So in this video we will study three examples related to calculation for delta G and equilibrium constant. So here is first example is calculate the free energy of delta G of a reaction mixture containing 1.75 atmosphere of NO2 and 0.5 atmosphere of N2O4 at 25 degrees Celsius. So 25 degrees Celsius is equal to 298 Kelvin. Once I will add 273, and the value for delta G for reactant and products are given here, and this is the reaction where 2 moles of reactant are reacting to make 1 mole of product. So for this reaction they are saying that we have to calculate delta G. So delta G is equal to delta G Z standard 0 degrees and plus RT natural log Q. So first I have calculated Q here. So Q is equal to pressure of N2O4, which is product, and pressure of NO2, raised power 2, because these two are the gases and the concentration of the gases are given in atmosphere. So the 0.5 N2O4 and 1.75 atmosphere of NO2. So we place the value and then calculate Q here. Next, we have to calculate delta G of this reaction. So delta G of this reaction will be equal to the sum of the total mole of the product gives free energy of the product minus total mole of the reactant and gives free energy of the reactant. So 1 mole product N2O4 and free energy is 98.28 kilojoule per mole minus 2 moles is here 51.84 kilojoule per mole. So once we'll solve this math, we'll come back that minus 5.4 kilojoule per mole, and then delta G standard will be minus 5400 joule per mole. And now we know delta GZ standard, and we know that the Q also. Now we can place these two values into this equation. Into this equation where delta G is equal to delta G standard plus RT natural log Q. And where this is we have already calculated, and plus R value is constant. This is temperature T natural log 0.163. So here Kelvin will be cancelled out, and then we can take a common joule per mole. Once we'll multiply this R value and temperature, it will come 2477.572, then multiplied by this negative value of natural log of 0.163, both will come negative. Once we'll add these two together, this is 5400 and minus 4494.33 joule per mole. Once we'll add together, the answer will come delta G is equal to minus 9.89 × 10⁻³ joule per mole. And then once we remove 10⁻³, we can write in the kilojoule. So this was the first example how to calculate the delta G in the non-standard condition. And another example is this one that we have to calculate here. K value is given for this reaction. So this is example number 2 where determine the Gibbs free energy change delta G0 in kilojoule per mole for the reaction for the aqueous dissociation of nitrous acid at 298 Kelvin, and Ka for this reaction is given. So nitrous acid is in equilibrium with hydrogen ion and nitrate ion. Delta G standard condition we have to find out. temperature is given, K is also given. So for this, these parameter, we are going to use this equation. Delta G in standard condition will be equal to minus RT natural log K, and here R value is constant, temperature is 298, natural log is 4.0 times 10 to the minus 4. So Kelvin will be cancelled out, and once we solve, natural log of 4.0 times 10 to the minus 4, it will come as minus 7.82, and then minus 2477.54. Multiply together, we'll get the positive answer, that 1.94 times 10 to the minus 3 joule per mole, or we can say that it is 1.94 kilojoule per mole. So this is the another application of this equation, where we calculated the delta G standard using K. And then we have one more third question, that this reaction is given for Haber equation. The standard free energy changes for the Haber process is 33.3 kilojoule per mole, or 33,300 joule per mole. Use the above value of delta G standard to calculate the equilibrium constant for the process. Now they are asking to calculate K here using delta G zero. So for that, we are going to use this equation. So K is equal to e raised power negative delta G standard by RT. So e negative in parenthesis delta G value joule per mole, and divided by R value 8.314 joule per mole Kelvin, then multiplied by temperature 298 Kelvin. So Kelvin cancel, and then here joule and mole will also be cancelled out. Once we solve this math, it will come K equal to e raised power 13.4, and then at the end we can calculate the K value. So these were the three examples related to the non-standard condition calculation for the Gibbs free energy, or Q, or K. So these are the three important equations you have to memorize, and you must know how to utilize these equations.